A recent champion has revealed that they are now a free agent, and we have the backstage reaction to CM Punk's controversial Instagram story. But first, we have an update on Bray Wyatt, who hasn't been seen on WWE television for a number of weeks, with his WrestleMania status currently up in the air. Well, according to a fresh report from PW Insider, Wyatt is set to miss yet another week of television, with them noting that neither he nor Uncle Howdy are scheduled to be at Friday Night SmackDown tonight, this being the second last episode of the Blue Brand before the big show. Recent reports have suggested that Bray has been missing from television due to personal health issues, issues that don't appear to be at the finish line just yet. WWE superstar Seth Rollins was hacked on Twitter this week, with fans noticing a sudden influx of NFT-related activity on his account. His occupation was also changed to state that he now works in financial services. Seth has since regained access to his account, and hopefully no one was fooled by the impersonation scam, but either way, Rollins has since taken to Twitter to respond to the incident, with him writing, "Sucker punched on a Monday, hacked on a Thursday, hell of a week. See yous in Salt Lake on Saturday, hashtag sing." Shinsuke Nakamura would walk through the proverbial forbidden door earlier this year, returning to his native Japan as part of the Great Muta's retirement tour, going on to work a match at a Pro Wrestling Noah event. This is a rare occurrence for a WWE superstar, who are almost always exclusive to WWE shows and events. According to Muta himself, the match could have been even bigger if the original plans played out, as he would tell ESPN this week that the two were originally set to clash inside the Tokyo Dome, which was the scene for the legend's final match. He would note that WWE didn't approve Nakamura for the show soon enough, which led to another opponent being picked. Instead, Nakamura vs. Great Muta would take place inside Budokan Hall on January 1st, rather than the February 21st Dome Show, with New Japan Pro Wrestling's Tetsuya Naito being chosen for the bout, this before old rival Masahiro Chono stepped up for an impromptu match. Great Muta now finds himself set for this year's class of the WWE Hall of Fame, which appears to have been the trade-off for allowing Nakamura to appear for Pro Wrestling Noah. Now we go to some major news coming out of Impact Wrestling today, who now find themselves without a world champion. The company have announced that their world title has now been vacated following an injury sustained to Josh Alexander, who is set to be out of action for a number of months. And Impact will break the news on Twitter, with them writing, "Breaking: Josh Alexander will relinquish the Impact World Championship due to triceps tears that will require surgery. Kushida will face Steve Macklin to crown a new champion on April 16th at Rebellion." The injury brings an end to Alexander's record-breaking 335-day reign, which made him the longest reigning world champion in company history, surpassing Bobby Roode's 256-day reign back in January of this year. Josh was originally set to defend his belt against Steve Macklin at the Rebellion pay-per-view, with him now being replaced by New Japan Pro Wrestling's Kushida. AAA Mega Champion El Hijo del Vikingo would stamp his mark on the American wrestling scene this past Wednesday on AEW Dynamite, with him stealing the show during his main event matchup with Kenny Omega. Well, Tony Khan hasn't waited around before booking Vikingo for another one of his shows, with him now set to make his Ring of Honor debut next Friday. The champion of AAA will put his mega title on the line against fellow roster member Commander at Supercard of Honor, which goes down in Los Angeles, California during WrestleMania weekend. But that wasn't the only title match announced for the show last night, as during the latest episode of Ring of Honor Television, it was confirmed that Claudio Castagnoli would defend his ROH World Championship against longtime rival Eddie Kingston in the main event of the show. There has now been 7 matches announced for Supercard of Honor thus far, with Mark Briscoe set to challenge Samoa Joe for the ROH Television title elsewhere, whilst the vacant ROH Tag Team titles will be hanging high in the air during the Reach for the Sky ladder match in honor of the late Jay Briscoe. And before we continue, why not drop a like down below if you're enjoying the video, and subscribe to the channel with notifications turned on so you don't miss the latest wrestling news, as we try to reach 50,000 subscribers by the end of the year. But with that said, let's get to the next story. On last night's news video, we would discuss the status of former WWE superstar Naomi, who took to Instagram to confirm that she is no longer with the company following her walkout in May of last year alongside Sasha Banks, aka Mercedes Moné. Well, soon after the news broke, a trademark filing name would appear on the USPTO website, filed by Naomi, real name Trinity Fatu, which appears to reveal her new ring name outside of WWE. On March 20th, Trinity would file for the term Trinity Star for use in wrestling contests, clothing, video games, toys, and other similar items. Whilst it remains to be seen where and when Trinity Star will show up next, it appears that she is preparing for a return to professional wrestling sometime in the near future. And now we have some news regarding the aforementioned Mercedes Moné, who is of course the IWGP Women's Champion of New Japan Pro Wrestling. It was recently reported by Dave Meltzer in the Wrestling Observer newsletter that Moné had just one match left on her deal with Bushiroad, the parent company of New Japan and Stardom. The match in question would see her put her title on the line against Mayu Iwatani, with many wondering if she was set to drop the title because of this. Well, it looks like more dates may have been agreed to, as a video was released earlier today revealing that Mercedes is set to appear at New Japan's Sakura Genesis on April 8th, this 15 days before the Grand Queendom event. In the video, Moné would accept a challenge from Azumi and Hazuki for a three-way match for the IWGP belt, with the winner then advancing to Grand Queendom to face Iwatani. Whilst this could suggest that Mercedes has at least two more matches on her contract, it could also be the case that she will now be dropping the belt sooner than first planned, although we will just have to wait to see how things play out. And speaking of the IWGP Women's Championship, the inaugural title holder, Kairi, would speak with WrestlingNews.co this week via her interpreter, where she would reveal her current contract status. During the chat, Kairi would reveal that despite appearing for Stardom and New Japan Pro Wrestling in recent months, she is actually a free agent able to appear wherever she chooses. Her interpreter would note, "She's a free agent. She would like to go anywhere possible, and she would like to go back to the US. She's a free agent." When asked about potential opponents in the United States, Kairi would name talents from both All Elite Wrestling and WWE, with her replying, "Saraya, Toni Storm, Jamie Hayter, Asuka, Io Sky, Bayley, Shayna Baszler, everyone." CM Punk would once again spark a ton of speculation regarding his future in All Elite Wrestling last night, when he responded to a post by Dave Meltzer on the Wrestling Observer boards, who claimed that the straight-edge superstar was less than cooperative, leading into the match that saw him lose the AEW World Championship to Jon Moxley in August last year. This led to Punk taking to his Instagram story to claim that AEW wanted him to work the match without being cleared to wrestle, hence the reluctance, whilst also claiming that Moxley refused to lose to him. Punk would also name drop Dave Meltzer, calling him a liar, before suggesting that he gets his information from Chris Jericho, who he called a stooge and a liar. Well, Fightful Select would today release a whole bunch of information regarding the matter, including more details on the events that led up to the match, the infamous media scrum, and the backstage brawl with the Elite, as well as the reaction to last night's post. Firstly, the report covers the topic of Jon Moxley, who reportedly had heat with Punk prior to the two matches in the summer. Fightful notes that Punk was in fact uncomfortable with competing in the August 24th match due to not being medically cleared at the time, much like his post stated, which led to backstage concerns that he wouldn't show. It was noted that if AEW is given a choice between Jon Moxley and CM Punk, the backstage belief is that they would side with Moxley if push came to shove. Punk is said to be very aware of the heat on him and the possibility of talent walking out should he return, although some of the heat has died down over recent months. As for an update on Punk's injury and potential return, Fightful would note that he and Tony Khan had spoken or had a couple of meetings, although it's unclear what or if anything came from this. One meeting was set for mid-February, although Jerry Jarrett's passing and funeral would delay this. The report would confirm that CM Punk did tear his tricep during the match with Jon Moxley at All Out prior to the media scrum and the backstage fight. The original hope from Punk was that he would be fully recovered by late January, although the feeling is that he'd be able to be cleared right now, if not soon. One source close to Punk revealed that whilst he originally wanted out of his AEW contract following the controversy, it was believed over recent weeks that he did want to return to the company. One person even claimed that Punk was willing to apologise for the All Out media scrum, although it wasn't clear if this would be public or private. Several people noted that Punk has expressed some form of regret for aspects of that night in general, but with that said, sources within AEW have now lost confidence that Punk will return to AEW. And before you go, make sure you check out the 12 most obscure WWE appearances from AEW wrestlers.